Greetings, this is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. The focus of my conversation today is on the fact that VW and their Porsche division just announced that they're installing 350 kW chargers at their headquarters in Germany, as well as their Atlanta US headquarters. This is an interesting strategy. Wanted to look at it and the implications relative to competitive of Tesla. Bonjour, wie geht's? Wie steht's noch immer? Auf zwei Beinen. Strasbice. Ni hao ma. Guten Tag. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. The thrust of my talk today, it really focuses on the fact that it's really interesting to watch the response from big automakers to the competitive threat that Tesla represents. It was announced within the last week, or the third week of July 2017, that the folks at VW/Porsche had now started installing 350 kW chargers at their headquarters in two locations. And I thought this was interesting because my initial reaction was, wow, the Model Y project, or the project, I think it's Project Y, that is described as the new electric Porsche 911 body with an electric engine, looks like it's going to be formidable. I mean, it's a good-looking car. We know it's going to perform because it's an electric vehicle. And now my initial thought was, wow, that's pretty amazing that they're going to be pushing at a 350 kW power rate into these vehicles. And I was thinking, okay, that makes sense. The Tesla superchargers currently are maxing at 150 kW. So in theory, given the current top charge rate for the supercharger, we'd have to assume you're charging three times as fast. If it takes 1 hour to recharge the entire battery for a Tesla, that means that in theory, in 15 minutes or so, you'd be fully charged on a large battery. So on the surface, it seems like sort of a Tesla competitive threat. Elon Musk has talked about pushing to the 350, even 500 or higher kW. I'm expecting that once Tesla enters the truck space, this will be fairly common. I was also intrigued because as we talk about charging at this rate, I was really fascinated by the issue of battery and cell management. So what I mean by this is that basically you're moving electrons either fast in or fast out of a vehicle. If you look at, for example, the ludicrous mode in Teslas, what's really going on there is that you're stressing the battery out to optimize performance. And the issue that pops up with this is that batteries have cells that have a certain life cycle. And if they're gently used, those cells are sort of stick around for longer. If they're pressed into sort of very high speed charge and a discharge on a constant basis, it shortens the life of the unit. So you start having, in essence, part of the cells no longer cycle through the process of charge and recharge. So I was really fascinated by the competitive move of VW Porsche looking towards that 350 as sort of a competitive step, especially on a car like $100,000 to $200,000 car like a Porsche, because all of a sudden you've got this interesting problem emerging of, wait a second, you're spending huge amounts of money on a car, you definitely have a garage for it, or you know, a high-end building that it's sitting in. In the interest of getting better and longer-term performance of your car, might you not want to just charge it slowly as much as possible, because the car just ends up hanging out longer and performing better because it's not been abused? So, you know, the answer might be the battery technology improved, so 350 kW in 5 years is no big deal. I did think it was an interesting move, but what it started triggering in my mind is the fact that one of the new or unique processes of ownership of cars starts to become how you take care of your battery, and are you treating it gently or are you abusing it all the time but expecting it to last a long time? And 350 kW does sound great, but at this level of battery technology, it just sounds like battery abuse to me from another angle, and folks with the kind of dollars that they've invested in their vehicle might be better served to, you know, simply take the 6 hours and be done with it in their garage, rather than trying to force all those electrons in at 350 kW. You know, there's one thing what the manufacturers are saying the car can and will do. It's another thing to see what battery degradation really is, because performance in the lab isn't often the exact what you see on the street. One quick thought that comes to mind on that is I actually saw a post from one of my users the last couple of days where they were saying that they've had a Model S since 2013 and it has 50,000 miles on it, but the range has now dropped from, I guess, 220 to about 190 miles at full charge. So I don't have anything to compare that to, but you know, what if that person used a supercharger a lot and ludicrous mode a lot, and you know, the distance range of their battery started to decline? So, you know, it'll be fun to exchange, you know, what do you think about this circumstance and battery management process and sort of getting the most life and best life out of your battery versus heavy duty performance at the front end that subsequently results in early demise of your battery. So thank you for taking time out to be with us once again. I think the move to the 350 kW is really interesting for, you know, as a competitive move by VwPorsche. I mean, they don't have a car that runs at that yet, so I think it's sort of a shot across the bow to show that they're committed long-term to this area, and that they intend to be a force. I don't know that it, I'd have to say if I owned a Porsche, I'd be more inclined to charge it slow and enjoy the performance longer rather than force it at the top level of its battery performance all the time, and therefore, you know, create other problems for myself. Look forward to your comments on this. Thank you for taking time out once again to view. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. Look forward to your comments and input. I definitely think battery management is part of what EV users have to learn about, and abusing your battery is not a great way to enjoy your car longevity-wise or to set it up to have a lot of residual value for subsequent owners, and this might affect whether or not they choose to purchase your vehicle, because they can sort of jump into the computer and see, you know, how this battery and car was managed, and that could be used against you as you, you know, try to move on to other vehicles down the road. At any rate, I look forward to covering this more further in the future. I'm intrigued because VW is one of the biggest brands in the world, so they have all kinds of resources for marketing, etc. I think it perhaps also shows the fact that Tesla's done such a good job of managing variables that consumers might think are important, that it's really left even the big players grasping for straws, trying to find ways to respond to the competitive threat. Look forward to covering this further into the future. Tschüss, macht's gut, au revoir, à tout à l'heure. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. Please like and subscribe.